Whenever I'm on set, I make it a point to put care into my appearance. And in doing so, I'm able to be one step closer into having a good shoot. I make the same point when I'm networking, or when I'm even at home with other tasks. Because self-care breeds self-confidence. And when I have the confidence, I'm halfway there to achieving anything I set my mind to. So let's start the day off by getting ready with me as we focus on the investment in appearance. Good morning, Bashers. I just got back from the gym.
Oh my god, I'm so sexy.
I'm feeling good, I'm feeling great, you know what I'm saying? Had a really good workout, upper body today, you know what I'm saying? Going to, what are you talking about? Anyways, I know on the last investment video, I was speaking on investments of health, right? So going to the gym, eating right and everything like that, you know what I'm saying? Just knowing your body, but mainly taking care of your body, right? Another thing when it comes to just being a creative and just being a worker and being a filmmaker, but primarily just being all around well-rounded, is an investment in appearance. When it pertains to the investment of appearance, one of my favorite cliches is, when you look good, you feel good. You know what I'm saying? I'll be trying to look good all the time and feel good all the time. And what I believe is, when you look good and you feel good, then you perform great. You feel me? So like, that's why for me, it's very important that I start my day off, you know, one, started off getting some good hours of sleep, because I wake up feeling pretty rejuvenated, my body feels good. But then also going to the gym, as soon as I wake up, you know, getting that fresh air and everything like that, taking my dog for a walk, you know, feeling really good. So I like doing that to start off the day. But then afterwards, coming home, taking a shower, and especially just kind of figuring out what I'm gonna wear. But I always try to have an idea of what I'm gonna wear the night before, just cause I'm all like, that way you're already prepared, right? For me, as you can see, you know, ain't got much going on up top, right? And grooming is a weekly thing for me. You know, I tend to shave my hair like maybe once or twice a week. You know, and depends on, you know, just how fast it's growing back. Same thing with when it comes to my beard, I'm gonna line that up. And when it comes to looking good, I got a lot of stuff to do today. And I'm gonna be out in public today. I'm gonna be editing about maybe, gosh, I'm editing an event. So I gotta edit clip by clip. So I'm gonna be in the cafe for a long period of time today. So with that being said, I'm gonna be out, you know what I'm saying? I wanna look good, I wanna feel good, and I wanna do great.
Preserves my sexy.
Let's start with the look good part. I feel good right now because I just, you know, got from the gym. You know what I'm saying? You see the boobies, all right? It was chest day. Pow, you know what I'm saying? What's up? Don't push me, cause I'm close to the edge. I'm trying not to lose my head. Oh, ho, ho, ho. I know y'all probably can't see it, but there is some hair growing back. I'm gonna shave it down, but I'm also gonna try something a little different today. So in this whole talk about the investment in appearance, I wanted to try some things out right here in front of y'all. Some things I've been having, you know, my eyes set on for a while now. Some of these things I've been having my eyes set on for years. Bevel, okay? Bevel Essentials, okay? So when it comes to Bevel, I've known about Bevel for about, almost 10 years now. I remember back when podcasters were promoting their razors. It's their razors for coarse, curly hair, basically for black people. Our skin isn't the best with razors. We're more prone to get razor bumps. So these razors, as you can see, are for us, by us, mind you. This is black founded, you know? So it's definitely something that I've been wanting to try out for years, especially once I, you know, shave my head. I've been bald for about 6 years now. Primarily I use an electric razor, but one thing that you know notice when you're bald is, you know, compared to an electric razor and a regular razor, when you use an actual like razor blade, your hair grows back at a slower rate. I got post shave bevel. So I made sure to grab everything that was needed for the step-by-step of like just the normal day shaving process. I could have bought the essential, the beginner packet, but I remember I saw it online and I was like, I ain't trying to wait. I just need to shave my hair now. And when I went to Target, they actually had it there, but by that point I had already bought everything. The Bevel pre-shave oil, okay? Let's see how this goes. So this helps prevent razor bumps. Dermatologist tested the Bevel difference. I really, you know, again, love the fact that there are, you know, people that look like me, people that have my skin tone, black men on the cover. It is, that gave me a lot of assurance, like, okay, this is for me. So you wanna massage a nickel sized amount into wet skin and hair. Okay, so let this slowly absorb for a few minutes before, for a few moments before applying the Bevel shave cream. All right, so let's go ahead and wet this face. Since I know I gotta, you know, moisture my face anyway, let's just kind of do it now. I got a, you know, daily facial cleanser, you know, and this has been doing nice. This is a nice refresh on the face. So we're just gonna wash this face now. You know, I got from the gym, I was pretty sweaty. So the crazy thing is I might end up using it again after I take a shower, but probably not, because I also picked up the Bevel face and beard wash. So I'll probably end up using that. I wanted to make sure I grabbed everything Bevel related, you know, that way, you know, I can give a legit review and make sure it all works. Get every part. Self-care, man, I'm telling you. Remember, you only got one body and you only get one face too, you know? You wanna make sure you're taking care of it, you're respecting it, you're nurturing it. You know, try to avoid greasy food, try to avoid a lot of alcohol, try to avoid tobacco and cigarettes, all that stuff that just, try to avoid heavy drugs, anything that, you know, can really mess with your appearance. How you looking wild out here, you know? Oh man, that look good. I haven't even done anything yet. I'm like, oh my God, I look great.
I'm sexy, I'm so sexy.
So for all my Yay fans out there, right? There is a mixtape from 2007 called the Can't Tell Me Nothing mixtape. It came out before Graduation had dropped. And there's a song on there. Well, it's actually a skit, and it's called Interviews. It's like called Interview Skit. And Kanye West is talking about his problem with interviews, right?
This is my problem with interviews, you know?
In a part of the skit, he's talking about the Rolling Stone magazine cover that he did, where he was, you know, basically looked at as Jesus, portrayed as Jesus on the cover. And they were like, oh, he has a God complex, which, later on down the line, you know, could be a valid argument now. But you know, in the skit, he was basically talking about how people were saying he has a God complex. And he was, one thing that stood out to me that I really understood and respected was the fact that he was like, you know, yo, I just wanted to do something different. Like, you know, I didn't want to do a magazine cover, another magazine cover where it's just like, I see my face and it's just like, hey, look, it's my face. You know, and after seeing my face so many times, shit, I get tired of seeing my face. I see me every day.
It's like I'm not allowed to be creative. So every cover I take has to just be a picture of my face and shit. Just, look, it's my face. It's me. And sometimes it's like after I see me so much, I get tired of me and shit. I gotta look at me every day.
For me, that's my mindset. It's like, okay, like, since I know I'm gonna see me every day, I want to be happy at what I see. I want to smile when I see me. I want to see myself in the mirror and be like, all right, Jenna, you're keeping it up. You're keeping it up. You know what I'm saying? You're looking good. You know what I'm saying? And of course, we all have those days where we see ourselves in the mirror and be like, yo, you down bad. You know? So I be trying to, you know, my goal is to really have less and less and less of those days as possible. And that comes with the discipline of, you know, taking care of my body and, you know, taking care of my appearance. Now that my face is moistured, we're gonna go ahead and do that pre-shave oil. Let me reread the instructions again. Massage a nickel-sized amount into wet skin and hair. If you know, you know. The neck is where you get the most annoying bumps. You know what I'm saying? I hate it. You know, like, that has been one of the benefits of using a razor, an electric razor, is you don't get no neck bumps for real like that. So this is gonna be the big part. Like, if it don't fix this shit, like, if it don't take care of that, I don't have any bumps right now. You know what I'm saying? So if it stays that way, then Bevel, you got my thumbs up. If after I use this, there are no neck bumps, you're a real one. But if there are, you won't know. I'm not getting paid for this. I bought all of this with my own money, okay? Into what's good. That's the area I want to shave for real. This has the most hair on it. Let's also get the neck. Notice I'm not putting it necessarily on the beard, I'm putting it right above the beard because I want to shave this part, the line. It's all about the discipline, right? For some people, I think it's like maybe 10, probably 11 o'clock in the morning right now. Right? All I gotta do today is go to the cafe. And I know there are people out here that work 9 to 5s. Completely understand. Get up earlier. Go to sleep earlier. Get up earlier. You know? Or do it, you know, on a day. Make the time to do it, you know? So if you don't do it in the morning, do it at night before you go to bed. You know, before you, take a shower, before, you know, after dinner, stuff like that. You know, if you got kids, put the kids to bed. When it's time for you to go to bed, okay, I gotta shave first. You know, that way I don't have to worry about doing it in the morning. Okay? It's really, it's all about priorities. It's all about priorities. And now it's time to apply the shaving cream. I need to mop my floor. This is the next step. So, after applying pre-shave oil, see, that's how they get you. If it don't work, they went, oh, you didn't apply the oil. Nope, I applied it. So after applying the pre-shave oil, squeeze a nickel-sized amount of shave cream onto wet bevel shave brush. I don't got a brush. Apply in strong circular motions and use a bit of speed and pressure to whip a bridge foamy lather. Shave with grain, shave with the grain in slow, short glides. Rinse with cold water, pat dry, and apply post-shave balm. I think this is after. Okay, this is way more than nickel size, but all right. Shaving my own hair has saved me thousands of dollars when it comes compared to going to the barbershop. In the past 6 years of being bald, I've only went to the barbershop once in 6 years. Still kept up appearance, still look great, and I've only been to the barbershop one time. And apply in strong circular motions, okay, to whip up ridge foam. We got all that going, okay. Shave with the grain in slow glides. Okay, so yeah, it's time to shave now. I'm gonna find out how many uses you can get out of a disposable razor. All right, let's try it out. This is nice. Bamboo. Comes with a little, it's like tissue. Okay. This Bevel Essential Pack, it comes with about 5 disposable safety razors. Again, for coarse curly hair. Clear shave gel, which I think I'm gonna put on here. Bump control aftershave. I'm gonna be using that afterwards. Ray, I don't get any razor bumps. Okay. So I hear it. I definitely hear it taking out the hair. I'm starting with the sides because the sides are primarily where a lot of my hair grows back. You ever seen that mugshot of Neo? Where you can tell he hadn't shaved in like a couple days. And like, it's a lot of hair right here on the side, but nothing up top. That's kind of how my hairline is. There are probably some people watching that are like, why are you shaving your hair? Like, you barely have any hair, right? It's called upkeep. It's all about the upkeep. You don't want to have an off day. You know what I'm saying? Because again, you never know who you're going to meet. My sister, she was the one that, you know, welcomed me to the cliche of, you know, when you stay ready, you ain't got to get ready, right? We had to go to the grocery store for something. And I remember I was looking really bummy. I hadn't taken a shower, just a lot of stuff. And I remember there was like people there that I actually wanted to like talk to and stuff like that. You know what I'm saying? Pretty girl that I might have liked or something. And I was like, damn, I'm looking bummy, you know? I was like maybe 13 at the time. And my sister was like, yo, if you stay ready, you ain't gotta get ready. You know, in the morning, take a shower, put on some clothes. You know, you never know when you're gonna have to head out the door. That piece of advice, you know, I always say to myself, like, you know, sometimes God talks to you through people. And I felt like that was God talking to me through her. So like that piece of advice always stuck with me. Since then, it's just always been about like, you know, upkeep. Yeah, I could let my hair grow out a little bit, but like I said, I'm going to the cafe. I could wear a hat, but what if I want to take it off? You can't be caught slipping. Can't be caught slipping. For a single blade, that was nice. Rinse with cold water, pat dry, and apply Bevel post-shave balm. All right, so I'm gonna take a quick shower. And then we are going to apply the post-shave balm. I think there is some razor bump prevention in there too, since I got a cut on my neck. I'm gonna apply that as well. One thing that I almost forgot, the beard and shave, the face and beard wash. About to pop this in right now. Had to make sure I use this because as I was washing my face, or as I was letting water run in my face, I was like, all right, I need to wash my beard and stuff like that. I was like, what am I gonna use? I remember I had this, the Bevel face and beard wash. Let's see how it works. We've used the pre-shave. We have used the shaving cream. We have used the disposable razor. We have now used the Bevel face and beard wash. Okay. By the way, I did a nice, you know, so they say use warm water. I used warm water. And then afterwards, I took a cold shower afterwards. Bruh, cold showers are some of the best things you can do. Cold showers are hands down some of the best showers you can have. Like, overall for your body and the benefits. That I can make a whole another video on the benefits of cold showers, but cold showers are where it's at. But you know, for this, I started off with warm water because that's what they recommended. Some parts of my head were felt a little irritation. A little sting in the shower. But honestly, now that I'm putting it on, I barely feel anything. This is nice. Okay, I feel it right there. Ah. So now we have the Bevel bump control. Alright, the Bevel bump control. What does it do? Okay. It exfoliates to help reduce bumps. I've been looking for an exfoliator, so the fact that I have that now, you know. I'm here for it. The Bevel difference. Our bump control is free of drying alcohols and helps avoid ingrown hairs and razor bumps. Made with a blend of green tea, I love green tea, and 10% glycolic acid. Okay, for smoother skin. All right. Sunburn alert. This product contains an alpha hydroxy acid that may increase your skin's sensitivity to the sun. And particularly the possibility of sunburn. Use a sunscreen, wear protective clothing, and limit sun exposure while using this product and for a week afterwards. The good thing about this is, it's officially fall right now. I'm just kind of give you a time frame. The sun has not came out at all today. It's been pretty chill. And I'll mainly be indoors anyway, so this is perfect. Alright, so let's use directions, use after shaving or any time in between. Massage a small amount over clean face. The face is clean now. And neck. Allow to dry. Finish with Bevel face gel. This is gonna be the, y'all see it, it is documented, y'all see me using it. So this is gonna be the make or break. If I have no razor bumps from this, the cut was in the center, so if I don't have any razor, if I have a razor bump in the center, I'm like, huh, it is what it is. But if I have them anywhere else, I'm like, Bevel was capped. I don't want that to be the case, because I've honestly been wanting to use this product for years. I've been wanting to use this brand for years.
Back of the neck, too.
I know there's some filmmakers right now, they're like, yo, isn't this a page for filmmaking? Yes, it's a page for creatives. It's a page for actors as well, and any actor knows you got to keep up your appearance if you want to land some really good roles. Overall, this is a page for people that just, you know, want to better themselves as a creative, and a part of that is feeling good and looking good, you know? I know I put out my best work when I feel good and look good. My best writing, best, you know, editing, all that. For the post-shave bomb, after shaving, massage a nickel-sized amount into clean, dry skin. So use twice daily, even on non-shave days. So either way, I'm gonna have to wait for my face to dry out. Cools without the sting. The Bevel Difference, our alcohol-free post-shave balm, helps reduce irritation with vitamin E, tea tree oil, and aloe vera, the last step to complete your Bevel shave. Good to know. While I'm allowing myself to dry off and everything, I can, you know, put on some clothes, mop my bathroom floor, you feel me? Clean my sink. Again, cleaning up after yourself is essential. You know, clean as you go, it'll help. Clean the shower. Basically, you want to clean as you go, you want to clean your sink. But you know, while I'm waiting for my face to dry, let me multitask. Let me go ahead and clean my bathtub because I just used it. I don't want any mildew to grow. I don't want any, like, you know, like how your towels, like, you know, your wall gets all black and everything. That's like mildew growing, and I don't want that. So I'm clean as I go. I'm, just do something with my time that's gonna benefit me later on and in the present. Let's clean this tub.
All right, so quick update on using Bevel. I'm not sure if it's just because my skin wasn't used to the blade, but unfortunately, I did get razor bumps. A lot of them. And maybe I shaved too low and my hair and skin weren't used to that either. Normally, I use electric close shave razors, and I haven't had any cuts on my head from it. With the Bevel, like any other razor, I felt the cuts afterwards.
I'm usually using an aluminum-free deodorant. Nickel size. Very minty. I would recommend closing your eyes when you're using this, because it is, the scent on this is really strong and I like it, but at the same time, that means it can be definitely dangerous if you get it in contact with your eyes. Even around, like you can feel it right here. And again, this was the final step, which makes sense because this is really strong. I like the effect, I feel it on my fingers, on my, I can't remember what it is, but it's maybe it's the oil. Yes, it is. It's like a eucalyptic oil. Like sometimes I'll steam my face in eucalyptic oil, where like I'll put like drops of eucalyptic oil in water and steam my face. I was doing that a lot during the pandemic. It definitely feels smooth. Definitely feels smooth on my skin. I really like the feeling. My skin is feeling great. I haven't had this feeling in a long time. It feels very nice, relaxed, and lathered. Not like you just put lotion on, but like you actually took the time to lather your skin and, like, you know, nurture your skin. That's how my face feels right now. And I really like that feeling. I'm not even a pretty boy, but I'm feeling good. I'm feeling right about now. Now let's just try these last things. This was a gift from my sister-in-law, Brittany. Follow her on YouTube. She has a great YouTube channel. It's called Brittany Jackson TV. I was telling her I wanted to, like, you know, get more skin type products for my face. And she was like, you know, I was telling her, I was like, you know, I be losing hours of sleep. So I'd be, you know, waking up like baggy eyed sometimes and just like, you know, just want to step out in the world, you know, looking right. She, you know, she devised these for me. So this is Good Molecules, something she recommended. Ultra hydrating facial oil formulated with camellia and sea buckthorn oils to hydrate, protect, and nourish. I was dating a girl earlier this year that used this. And I'll see her do this every morning, where she like take these drops and she like drop it like on her face or something. And like, I always wonder like, what was that? And then, you know, one day she showed me and I was like, okay, like, you know, she let me try it out. And I was like, interesting. You don't have, like, if you don't have the time in the morning, do so when you have the time and make the time. It's all about making the time, right? Like, so if you don't have the time in the morning, go for the night. If you don't have the time in the night, go for the afternoon. Whenever you have free time, make the time to do this. Is all I have this to do, I have that to do. Make the time. You make the time to eat, right? You make the time to grab food. You make the time to go out and party. Make the time to take care of your face. Make the time to take care of your appearance. Make the time to take care of your home. I don't have kids. I don't have a wife or anything like that. I don't have a girlfriend. So, you know, I have to take care of myself. And it's a daily thing. Once you gain that discipline to do so and invest in yourself, everything else is a walk in the park, man. I'm telling you. I didn't even have to put on any lotion, which is great. I'm gonna put on some for my body, but I didn't have to put anything on for my face, which is job well done on my end. So we're gonna go ahead and get ready. I kind of already know what I'm gonna wear for the day because I picked it out the night before. And we're gonna get ready to start the day.
Now again, that could be due to the fact that my skin isn't used to the blade, but that was kind of the whole reason why I bought into Bevel in the first place. Because this was supposed to be a razor for my type of skin and my type of hair specifically. A part of me is willing to give it another chance, but a part of me is also not wanting to go through a razor bump trauma again. So for people that continue to use Bevel, let me know if that happened to you the first time around and if anything has improved since then.
As you can see, you know, what we like to say is, it's about having that shit on, you know what I'm saying? We got a fall look going on. Got on some Dickies, you know what I mean? You know? And I think we're just gonna lay it back with this flannel. It's gonna be a high of like, I think 79 degrees, so, you know, it's not gonna be humid, thank God. Thank God we're out the humid phase of, you know, the weather. Yeah, so now we're out of that phase. So now I can actually wear long sleeves, but I can still wear a tank top because it's not like it's like 60 degrees or 50 degrees outside. So, yeah, right now I'm just trying to see if this piece is needed, if it's necessary. And, I mean, allow my accessories to express themselves. We're gonna roll with it, we're gonna rock with it. A lot of men that I know, they say you should never leave the house without a watch, so and tell what time it is. Bling loud. I feel good, I look good. I'm able to, like, you know, just move out in the world really comfortable knowing that, you know, I took the time to actually take care of myself. I'm actually packed away too. And again, just letting my accessories speak for themselves. For the shoes, it's the fall time. Bring out the Chelsea boots.
Buddy, move, you gotta move. Move, move, move.
All right, so we got the Chelsea boots going. Very subtle. Yeah, I like it. Very subtle, very subtle. Definitely adult. It's a Wednesday. Not too much. We'll tuck this big one in for now. And then when I actually get to like the cafe, I'm gonna probably let it hang out a little bit. But yeah, this is where we're going with it. I'll rock with it. Not too much. But definitely just enough.
Okay.
It's 79 degrees, so I don't need it, but, you know, it doesn't hurt. And again, this goes back into the whole thing of, like, clearly I just shaved, so, like, I definitely don't need it, but if I want to have options, so, like, if I want to take my hat off, you see, I'm good. If I want to keep it on, You see, I'm good. They always say entertain, I pen a long brain. Life handed them lemons, life gave me lemonade. The protocol in the brain, they got body highs. No wonder I can hear what you saying. You ain't no super saiyan. I got Bowman and Chi-Chi up in Chef's playpen. They stay in the playpen cause I mix that bass in. I'm Chef. Sometimes I think deep in my mind. Above all, make sure you're good out there when you step into the world. Be sure to like and subscribe and leave a comment below for any appearance testimonies you have. Until next time, Bashers.